What's up, everybody? Man, it's your boy, Mr. Dugard, coming at y'all with another video, man. Yeah, man, and tonight I'm going to talk about Game 3 of the NBA Finals. You got the Eastern Conference champs, the Toronto Raptors, beating the Western Conference champs, Golden State Warriors, 123-109 to take a 2-1 lead in this NBA Finals series, yo. Granted, yeah, it was no Durant out there. Granted, it was surprisingly no Klay Thompson out there. Granted, DeMarcus Cousins looked at healthy game two. Looked like he ain't healthy again tonight. You know, granted with all that, yo. Shout out to Toronto on getting this win, man. I know a lot of people believe that Toronto should have won this game. You know, with all the guys, the big-time players for Golden State that's either not playing or hobbled. But, I mean, the win over there in Oracle Arena with Steph Curry cooking like he was cooking, that's still an impressive win for Toronto, man. Shout out to Kawhi Leonard. He put in 30 points, did his thing. Kyle Lowry had a big-time game with 23 points, man. Serge Ibaka turning back the clock, man, had, like, I think, like, 6 blocks out there, man. Pascal Siakam did his thing, especially in the first half. Van Vliet, man, is continuing to just knock down big shots. You know, Gasol played well tonight. Surprisingly, for the first time, really, in my eyes, all playoffs, you know, he was doing this thing down low on the block. You know what I'm saying? Usually, he's more of a jump shooter, but tonight, he got down in the paint and, you know, he did his thing down in the post. You know, so, I mean, they did their thing tonight, man. Credit, like, that. I know, like I said, a lot of people feel like because this player out, that player out, that it was going to be an easy win. But by all means, man, like, it's not easy beating that team in that building. You know what I'm saying? In these circumstances, man. But shout out to them, man. Big time win. And for Golden State, man, Steph Curry just was straight cooking tonight, man. 47 points for Steph. You know, he also had a good bit of assists and some rebounds. He was diving on the floor even late in the game. You know, he pretty much emptied the tank tonight, man. Shout out to him. He did everything he could to put this team on his back and try to get the W. But, I mean, it just – obviously, they ain't had enough. You know what I'm saying? I mean, Klay – I really thought Klay was going to play in this game, man. So, right before the game, when I seen Klay wasn't going to play, I'm like, man, that's kind of surprising, you know. May let you know his hamstring injury is a little more significant than we thought. You know, Boogie Cousins, man, after a nice game two, I mean, he didn't give him nothing tonight, man. I mean, it looked like he was running in quicksand. I mean, the brother couldn't even move tonight, man. Like, it wasn't his best performance, man. And Draymond, you know, he does a lot as far as facilitating and, you know, defending and getting rebounds and stuff like that. But, you know, he's not a prolific scorer. You know, every now and then you could get, like, game 7 of the finals in 2016. He had, like, 30-something points. But for the most part, Draymond not going to give you a lot of points like that. You know, he going to do a little bit of everything, but he's not a secondary scorer because, you know, Cousins not healthy enough to be that guy. And Draymond couldn't do it, so pretty much all the scoring was mostly on Steph. And for the most part, he handled his business. Every time it looked like Golden State was going to, like, really chip into this lead or have a chance to take the lead, man, Toronto would make a big shot, man. Whether it was Kyle Lowry with a three, Van Vliet with a three, you know, Kawhi with a shot. I mean, they just made timely run-killing shots all night, man. And that's what it's about, yo. Obviously, I picked Golden State in 6 before this series started, which means they would have to win the next 3 straight. You know, I'm not going to get off of that yet, man. I mean, I feel like Klay is going to play game 4, and I feel like Durant going to play game 4. At least, for their sake, he better. You know what I'm saying? I feel like if Klay and Durant play game 4 and they're relatively healthy, you know, Golden State still has a shot to run the table. But I will say, man, Toronto is playing really good basketball right now. And, I mean, their confidence should be sky high. I mean, game 4 is a huge game, man. A huge game, yo. Toronto has a chance to go up 3-1 with game 5 back in Toronto. Or Golden State has a chance to knock this thing up in 2 and turn these NBA finals into a best of 3. You know, so we're going to see what happens game four, man. We're going to see if Klay going to be able to go. We're going to see if Durant going to be able to go. You know, they was real short-handed tonight. Steph had a you know, heroic effort, but they just came up a little short, man. I mean, you can't expect much from guys like Jarepko and McKinney. You know, you could, in spurts, yeah, but to really go out there and score, nah, man. And Livingston, you know, didn't really have a good game. He started for Klay tonight, and I mean, he didn't have a good game at all, in my opinion. Hardly played in the second half, you know. But looking forward to game for Friday night, man. It should be a good one. Let's see if Klay and Durant go get back out there, man. But for right now, Toronto doing their thing, man. Shout out to the Raptors, yo. But with that being said, man, that's all I got for y'all tonight. Appreciate y'all checking out the video. Go on, give me a subscribe, man. I'm going to have NBA content, man, throughout the year. Y'all have a blessed one. Let's go Heat.